a revolutionary. And you're going to have to keep on saying that. You're going to have to say that I am a proletarian. I am the people. I'm not the pig.
You... Here's your water and your mask. Keep this on you all the time.
You know, I know a lot of people, you know, that hear things like this and see things like this, couldn't understand the motive behind this. Some of us young people, you know what I mean, I know a lot of people couldn't understand. See, me myself, you know, I was born in a so-called bourgeois community and had some of the better things you could see in life. And I found that even some of the better things of life for black people wasn't too cool. And I found that it was more people starving than it was people eating. And I found that more people didn't have clothes than they did have clothes. And I found that I just happened to be one of the few. And I made a commitment to myself that I wouldn't stop doing what I'm doing until all those people are free. A lot of times I wanted for it to be possible for people to be free under capitalism. I wanted to, for socialism to be able to be brought about through means other than violent means. But those were times when I was trying to be subjective. I was looking at things and trying to make them the way I wanted to make them be. Because I didn't mind dying, but I just thought, well, everybody shouldn't have to die. What we're saying is that we're more than people that are for armed struggle. We're people that are for armed struggle. For the purpose of bringing on the people's revolution, for the purpose of setting up initially a socialist state, and for the purpose, secondarily, of advancing into what you could call utopia or what we would call a communist state. We're saying that by observation and participation, by educating and by arming and by teaching the people revolutionary political power, we think that we as the vanguard can move those people that need to be moved that way. We can let those people ride our backs as oxen down the path of social revolution. And on and on and on, and finally, like we said, utopianism, what you call communism. We're very confident that nobody's coming in the front door. Nobody. No gas.
Nobody getting on the roof, Jim. I want you to know that. Nobody getting on the roof.
You believe in, what is it? Fire, cover, and fire?
The Minister of Health and doctor are going to be covering me while I'm loading up.
Now, see, in all the given situations, like when you're trying to frighten enemies, see, because when you got Christ on him, and you got full power too, you won the battle.
What do you say? Yeah, well, look here. What do you say about this building?
Building, right over here on West, around the corner of West. I think about 10, 12 stories.
It's higher than this.
Yeah.
Now, see, the only way we can get him is out shoot him, or give him more firepower. See, we can keep him pinned down. He can't get up and shoot if there's too many bullets coming at him. So the only way that we can get him is out shoot him, put too much firepower on him where he can't jump.
Okay. Therefore, what you're saying is we got to eliminate, just throw that process out of our mind by firing from the balance, like that.
No. You just that and a whole lot of semi-automatic and automatic action on him over there, and he ain't got no time to sight nobody.
That's right.
Just keep it down.
You might think sound reaction there on my part, man, but I just wish they would come tonight.
Yeah, well, I want them to come.
I wish they would.
The Minister of Defense. I say to the people.
Why don't you get a military viewpoint of how much chance they got of coming up here?
No, it's impossible.
What is Eric said? It's a difference between 20 million niggas and 20 million niggas armed to the hill.
This is impossible, man. I ain't bullshit. I ain't know. And I didn't realize it, man.
No. 007.
Yeah, Jack, but
see, we put Rush out there and you, and he won't even be able to get up. Two ain't.
Hey, we aren't asking for no war.
No, but the way I see it,
trying to take this here office. I think the people would have their first people's victory.
Wait a minute, who was that? Wait a minute, you?
We are drawing the line right here. Pigs will come no further. They are not going to make us retreat. We are going to have somewhere, no matter how far we run, no matter how long we have to run, that when we reach that point, we are going to be able to stop and say in the voice of hearing we say it is, that motherfucker, and what you fucked, you dig? Because I got my gun, motherfucker, and you got yours. And if you try to shoot me with your gun, motherfucker, if you try to take my gun, well, then I intend to blow your motherfucking brains out. That's what it's got to be about. That's what it's got to be about.